Coming up, we take a look at a local company that has been building competition water ski boats for over 50 years. Welcome to Central Florida on the Water. This is your host, Lou McNally. Florida's home to one of the most famous and iconic ski boat brands in the entire world, Ski Nautique. They've been built in Orlando for over 50 years by Correct Craft. The inboard ski boat design that they pioneered became the template for competition ski boats worldwide. I'm joined by the CEO of Correct Craft, Bill Yeargin. Bill, welcome to the program.
Lou, it's good to be here.
Glad to have you. Tell me a bit about how the company got started, would you?
It's a really interesting story. We started in Orlando in 1925 by a gentleman named W.C. Malone.
Okay.
And the company's got a very rich and storied history. It's built a lot of different products throughout the years. Helped build boats across the Rhine for World War II for General Eisenhower. Actually went through a bankruptcy in the early 60s, but spent 25 years repaying the creditors, even though they were fully discharged. And in the early 60s, really the company, the direction of the company changed with the Ski Nautique.
With Ski Nautique,
yes,
that
sir.
Really kind of just drove it to where it is today.
Yes, sir,
much, right?
It did. Yeah.
Now, you've gotten a little larger than just Orlando, haven't you?
Oh, yeah. We have manufacturing in five plants in four states across the country between Florida and California.
Mm-hmm.
We have a couple water sports parks, one in Orlando, one in Miami.
Wow.
And we have operations, distribution, and events in 70 countries around the world.
Wow. Well, let's take a look at the boat itself, or perhaps we have a little bit of video here about your operation. We'll see if we can take a look at that. This is your location here in Orlando, is that right?
Yep, that's just a little bit east of the airport, off 528. That's our factory. It's Correct Craft's world headquarters, and also the headquarters in Nautique Boat Company, our biggest subsidiary.
I gotcha. So you're making the boats right here, right?
Yep, we're making the boats right here. You see some of the awards there. We win all of our industry's awards, Boat of the Year, Most Innovative Product, and Manufacturer of the Year, many others.
Mm-hmm. That looks like an old Chris Craft.
No, that's actually one of the original Ski Nautiques from 1961.
My goodness. So you really had to design something specific just for water skiing? There hadn't been anything before that?
No, not really, Lou. For most of the history of water skiing until the early 60s, had been done by outboard boats.
Right.
But it created a very rough wake behind the boat.
I remember that.
When the Ski Nautique became an innovation because it had the engine in the center of the boat.
Oh.
When the engine in the center of the boat, Lou, leveled out the center of gravity of the boat, which made much smaller wakes behind the boat.
Which is good for...
It's great. Skiers love that. They want to go across those smaller wakes.
Why is that important?
Well, because it helps them perform much better. They're not bouncing across the water, and they can push themselves a lot further without the risk of injury.
Well, what are some of the things that make the boat unique in its design?
Well, the center engine is one big item. Another item is tracking fins.
This was a
new invention that came with the Ski Nautique, tracking fins underneath the boat that help keep the boat straight. People say driving a Ski Nautique or riding behind it's like being on a rail.
Ah.
Hold straight. And that's good for the skier because it gives them a consistent pull behind the boat.
Okay. Now, one of the family members that started Correct Craft, Walt Malone, right?
Yeah.
He was the original...
W.C. Malone, which was Walt Malone, founded the company in 1925. And there were a series of Maloons that followed him. We still have some in the company, even though the Maloons no longer own the company.
Okay.
In fact, the president of our Nautique brand is Greg Malone, the great-grandfather, the great-grandson of the founder.
I think we actually do have some video of Walt, who was the original founder.
No, Ralph.
Oh, Ralph.
Ralph Malone is still with us today.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to be 99 in a couple of weeks.
Goodness.
And he still
Don't
comes.
Tell me he's still skiing.
No, he's not skiing anymore, but he's not far from it. He comes in every day, and he's a real encouragement to our team, and... we love having him visit with us.
Well, that sounds great. I think we're going to have some video of Mr. Malone coming up for you right here.
China called up and begged me, please come over here and help us get started with water skiing. And boy, they bought 18 ski Nautiques. First purchase they had. Then they said, called me up and said, we don't know what to do with them now. We don't know how to drive them. We don't know how to do anything with them. What can you do to help? So I got our chief mechanic, and we went over, Betty and I, and he, and we went over there and taught a school. And we did everything we could to get them as prepared as possible. Then we finally, after we get through, tell them all about the boat, why then we began showing them how to grease the wheel bearings. And they couldn't understand why are we want you to tell us about the boats, how to do that. But I said, you don't understand. We back the trailer into the water, and if you don't grease the wheel bearings, why the wheels will fall off. And they still didn't understand. So on the way over, the Jeep that they had broke down, and we finally had to get the Jeep going and get it there. They had 50 Chinese men and 25 ropes, and they were going to pick that boat up and walk it down and put it in the lake. And I said, no, you don't do it that way. Then I tried to back it in there. I couldn't keep the old Jeep they had running. So he was running it and doing the steering of it. I did the steering, and he just kept the engine running, and I backed into the water. And then we got it around to the dock, and they just jumped one after another until we had about 30 people in that boat. I said, you can't do that. We only get six of them in here. That's all we do. And when they didn't know how fast it was going to go or anything, I tell you, I never saw such a picture in my life. When I hit that throttle and that bow came up and started off, I'm telling you, they get like they are seasick. They never had this. And then when I get the other side of the lake and turn the boat, same thing happened. I mean, it was just very difficult for them to get used to. But boy, I'm telling you, they entertained us.
What a character. My goodness, we all should be so lucky at 99. Right now, was that your first foray into foreign lands?
Ralph was telling the story about Ski Nautique going into China.
Right.
And Ski Nautique is the company and the brand that took water skiing around the world. Because none of the world knew about Ski Nautique or knew about water skiing. It was mainly done here in Central Florida. But Ralph really led the effort, went behind the Iron Curtain, took the boat into places where a lot of Americans couldn't go with product, but they wanted the top-end product to be able to compete on an international basis. And so Ralph was the guy who really led that around the world.
Well, how did the evolution of the boat itself change the sport of water skiing?
Well, the combination of switching to fiberglass, which is what happened when the Ski Nautique came out, created a more consistent, lighter boat. Mm-hmm. The center engine changed the center of gravity of boat, and the tracking of fins that we talked about all created a much better experience. And you can see here,
so it's got a really flat wake behind.
Really flat wake behind the boat. This is our Ski Nautique 200, which has been out on the market now for a few years. Many, many world records. In fact, I think 19 or 20 at last count world records. That's trick skiing.
That's a different wake, though.
It's a little different wake. They adjust the boat. The boat's going a little slower to create a little bigger wake for the trick skier.
Right.
And that can be done behind the same boat by just adjusting the speed a little bit. And this is jumping. And jumpers need a strong, consistent pull.
I would imagine.
Because they're putting their life on the line every jump, as you can see. So they need a good boat that has a strong, consistent pull, and you can do that behind the Ski Nautique.
See, driving one of these boats is just as much of a skill.
Yeah, it's absolutely. The top athletes want the top drivers, because you want to hold that boat steady, you want to keep it a steady speed, which we do through GPS control, speed control. But it's driving the boat's really important to the athletes.
Now, over the last decade or two, the wake sports have really started to come into their own. Are these specialized ski boats work for that too, or do you need a different boat? Or
you can behind the ski boats, but you really need a different boat. We make those boats too. Mm-hmm. Those are what we call our super air Nautique boats. And this really started happening in Lou in the 90s.
Okay.
And skiing, water skiing used to be almost 100% of the boats that we sold. Mm-hmm. And during the 90s, it started transitioning to wakeboarding.
Right.
And wakeboarding, you wanted bigger, heavier boats with the engines in the back of the boat to push the back of the boat down to create a bigger wake. You can see there.
Well, that's a huge wake, yeah.
Yeah, basically, you want to create a ramp for the wakeboarder. So the wakeboarder will go and they'll jump over the ramp and do all kinds of tricks. Tricks behind the
so
boat.
So that's all done by just positioning the motor in the rear and a deeper hull, perhaps?
Or? Yeah, a little deeper hull, transitioning the motor to the rear. But there's also ballast tanks. And the ballast tanks in some of our boats can hold up to 2,800 pounds of water.
Whoa.
They go into the boat and that they go into tanks inside the boat, push the boat down in the water. But hull design is also important. A lot of companies try to create wakeboard boats and wakeboard behind the boats. But mm-hmm. the hull design, our team spends a lot of time tweaking the hull to get it specifically designed to create the smoothest, biggest wake.
The wake they want. So, I mean, you can have big wakes, you can have little wakes. My goodness. All right. We have a picture coming up of one of the designs here. I want to ask you a couple of questions on that. There are new features coming out all the time, too, right?
Oh, yes. I mean, We're very innovative. We win almost every year Innovation of the Year, or Most Innovative Product for our product throughout the boating industry.
Look at that thing.
And that's like a
police cruiser. What's up with the tower?
That's the G23. That's our most popular boat. The tower is used, obviously, you can see there for speakers and great music, but it's more importantly used to connect a rope to help the skiers go up the ramp and get a little more elevation.
Elevation
when they're jumping.
Now, is this one of those little fins you're talking about?
Yeah, on the bottom you can see the tracking fin, and that is that's our GS20. That's our newest model. That actually is designed, Lou, to be able to water ski, wakeboard, and wake surf all behind the same boat, which is very innovative in the industry.
Very few
boats can do that.
How do you do that? Is that just adjusting the ballast tanks and things like that?
So that's part of it, but it's really a couple of years of our designers, our engineers spending time in the engine and spending time in the water creating the best possible hull mm-hmm. design for the boat.
Right.
And so that as we adjust ballast in the boat, we can also adjust the wake to create great water ski wake and great wakeboard and wake surf wake.
Wakeboard, too. What about the surf system? I've heard about...
wake surfing has really taken the world by storm in the last few years.
This is a step above wakeboarding, right?
Yep.
Because you're not being pulled by a rope anymore?
Well, actually, you get up with a rope,
okay.
You're behind the boat, and then you get in the wake with a surfboard, and you throw the rope. There you go. You can see an example of it. You throw the rope in the boat, and then you can surf behind the boat. You know, you can see here, you can actually use your watch to switch the speed.
What's he adjusting there?
Well, he's adjusting... That's an Nautique surf system. And that that diverts the water in a way that helps creates the biggest possible wake.
Because in this situation, you want the highest possible wake you can possibly
get. You want the highest possible wake behind the boat. And again, you know, the Nautique surf system wins Innovation of the Year. We won just again for the fourth year in a row,
mm-hmm.
Wake Surf Boat of the Year. So it's very innovative product that creates a great customer experience.
So you basically do these boats soup to nuts, right? I mean, from design all the way through to finished product.
Yep,
right?
we design. It starts with an idea,
mm-hmm.
and then we design it. We have an engineering team. We spend a lot of time prototyping. We'll spend months with boats on the water that we're making tiny little tweaks
mm-hmm.
to the hull to see if it makes the wake better, make the wake worse.
Mm-hmm.
The vast majority of boat companies that build boats, they want to build a nice, pretty, comfortable boat. We want to do that too, of course, Lou, but the most important thing about our boats isn't what happens in the boat, it's what happens behind the boat.
Right.
Because we got to create either a big wake for wakeboarders or a big wake behind the boat for wake surfers or a really small wake for water skiers. That's what makes Nautique boats unique.
We haven't taken a look here at your operation.
We're in the factory. We've got a state-of-the-art factory. I've been to probably 30, 40 boat manufacturing plants around the world, and there's none that there's none that's as nice as what we have right here in Orlando. In fact, your viewers are welcome to come by and take a tour. We give tours almost every day of the plant.
So that's an injection mold there, right?
Injection molding system, and it's a really unique state-of-the-art plant. This is, they're pulling the boat out of the mold after it's been laminated and gel-coated.
Of course, you got the harnesses, you got the
We have CNC machines that cut upholstery, cut fiberglass. And I encourage people to come by and take a look at it themselves. As I said, we do tours every day, and people are welcome to come by and see what we do. It's really an interesting process. This is our upholstery shop. All the upholstery in the boat is built by our team. Mm-hmm. We've got about 75 people who work just in upholstery.
Look at that.
And
well, of course,
it's
that's part
a very,
of it,
very high-end, high-quality upholstery.
So how many different boat lines are you manufacturing, and how many boats a year? And
well, we're building, Correct Craft overall is building about 4,500 boats a year. Close to 2,000 of them are built in Orlando at the Nautique plant. As I mentioned, we have a number of, we have six boat companies, so we're building a number of different boat brands across the country. But what you're seeing now is the Nautique plant, which is a little less than half of our total.
Is that your motor too?
Yeah, actually, we build the motors in South Carolina. We own the an engine company, Pleasure Craft Engine Group, and we build the motors. We sell them to our own boat companies, but we also sell them to boat companies outside of the Correct Craft.
Now, do they have to have any kind of special criteria, or is it just a good, powerful motor?
It's a good, powerful motor. It's got to be a high-quality motor because, especially with the wakeboarding and wake surfing, you're plowing, you know, a lot of water.
Right.
And so, you know, it's got to be a high quality motor. But you can see here, this is our test lake. The boat doesn't have any decals on it. You can see this is being tested. Every one of our boats spends about an hour on the test lake, Lou. And we go through the boat from bow to stern, and the guys on the test lake have a checklist that they go through. You won't believe how many people want that job.
Oh,
that's
bet.
A popular job.
Yeah.
That's a popular job.
I don't think I'd get sick of that either.
No,
I
mean, they spend the day out having fun on the lake. So
let's talk a bit about the work and the workforce there.
Yeah.
You have a number of people working there, right?
We've got about 1,000 employees total. We've got about 450 in Central Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a wide range of employees, and you know, they go through the whole process from product development to manufacturing, of course, sales, marketing, all the administrative functions. And we have an international sales team. I mentioned we operate in 70 countries around the world.
Wow.
So it takes a big team to put on events all over the world.
Here's Angela Pilkington to explain some of the employment needs at a factory like this.
Hi, I'm Angela Pilkington, the CFO of Correct Craft. Here at our world headquarters in Orlando, Florida, at Nautique Boat Manufacturing Facility, we employ 450 people. Our workforce consists of a variety of positions, some skilled and some unskilled. Some of the skilled positions we actually are having problems filling at this time. They include in our upholstery department, where we build the actual seats for our boats, we have problems finding sewers. As you probably are aware, they don't teach sewing anymore in schools. So this is a position we're actually very concerned about. And then gel coating is another position that it's hard to fill positions because it's a very highly skilled job, and people need to know how to paint really to do this. And that's the first layer of the start of our boats. So in addition to that, we have positions in our lamination department. These are people that roll fiberglass and resins, and that builds the foundation of our boats. We also have assemblers, and this is a position that's really actually unskilled. We can hire people that don't know how to do that and teach them in-house. We also have a machine shop that is a skilled labor too, where we build some of the metal parts that go into our boats. We have CNC cutters in-house too, which require people to program them. This is a skilled labor, and it cuts glass and it cuts some of the plastics in our boats. And of course, we have our designers and our engineers that have degrees and that are designing and engineering our boats. And then of course, industrial engineers that are also degreed people that are working on continuous improvement in our plant processes and also cutting costs.
It's five plants you have, is that correct?
Five plants in four states. We have six boat companies. We have a bass boat company, a walleye boat company, an aluminum fishing boat company. There's a lot of catfishing.
Mm-hmm.
And three towboat companies. Towboats are what you call the boats that pull the wakeboarders, water skiers.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Beautiful. Now, are you expanding anywhere else?
Oh, yeah. We're looking to continue to grow. We're growing significantly, but we're also in The cable park business.
Oh, a theme park in Central Florida.
Orlando Water Sports Complex. We've also got Miami Water Sports Complex. And it's a lot of fun. Effectively, you can water ski or wakeboard on a pulley system that goes around the lake. You see wakeboarder.
Doesn't look like you have to worry about any neighbors on the wake on that kind of a situation, do you?
It's a lot of fun. It's different than boat wakeboarding. They're both a lot of fun. A lot of people that get into cable wakeboarding eventually end up wanting to do the boat wakeboarding. So
gotcha.
It's a great way to introduce people to our sport.
Mm-hmm. So are they training for jumps and slalom and pretty much anything, right?
Yep. These guys are training for wakeboard competition, but it's not just training. The public's welcome to come out and just have fun. You don't have to do what these guys are doing. You can just go out and take a lesson and ride around, and it's a lot of fun. It's a great way to get your exercise in, and I do it often. I do it quite a bit.
How difficult is it to learn to just get up on a wakeboard?
It's really not difficult at all. You know, we have great coaches. We have mm-hmm. what's called the get-up guarantee,
uh-huh.
which if you want to come by, we'll guarantee you get up, or we'll keep working with you until you do, or give your money back. But that just doesn't happen because we've got great coaches. And you're interested, we can get you up. You need to come by, Lou.
Well, that sounds like a lead into our tip of the week this week, which just happens to be about your get-up guarantee.
Okay.
And Jordan Gaudette from the Orlando Water Sports Complex is going to show us how to get started riding at a cable park.
Oh, hey, how's it going?
Hi, Eric, I'm Jordan. I'm going to be your instructor today.
Awesome.
Welcome to Orlando Water Sports Complex. So you got a get-up guarantee?
Yes.
Have you ever wakeboarded before?
Never.
All right, we're going to learn today.
All right.
So we're going to go do our lesson on the 2.0. It's a two-tire system. It's by far the easiest way how to get up on a wakeboard.
Awesome.
You ready to go ride?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. So how we're going to get up, we're going to use a seated chair position to let that board float. Pull your knees up, your toes up, and your arms out, just like this. So you're just, keep those arms out. So you're going to hold this position. You're gonna feel an urge to maybe try to stand, maybe try to pull those arms in. All I want you to do is hold this position. It's the position that's gonna get you up.
Okay.
All right. So I'm gonna start you off nice and slow. Just hold that position. Here we go. You all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
You good? All right, I'm gonna bring the handle back to you. All right, so this time, keep those arms out, keep those knees bent.
Bent like this?
Bent just like that. I'm gonna tighten up the rope. All right, here we go. Remember, it's that position that's getting you up. Knees up, toes up, arms out. Get those arms out. Let those arms out. There you go. All right, nice and easy. Good. All right, here we go again. Knees bent. Just like that. All right, so good position. Knees bent, arms out, toes up. Here we go, Eric, you got this. Just like that. Woo!
Jordan has a good time doing that, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. Everybody does. Everybody does.
So it looks pretty easy. You just show up and somebody will help you, and it's a get-up guarantee.
Absolutely. And this is him transitioning over to the full cable, and anybody can do it.
So you have different speeds and different levels of difficulty.
Well, we have two cable systems. We have the standard cable system, which beginners to intermediates use, and we have an advanced cable system which goes a little faster, and that the more advanced riders and the professionals use.
Well, now you're a real events-driven company. Kind of have to be, right?
Yep.
Because of your specialized product. Tell us about that.
Well, we like to introduce our events, our product, through events all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
And we have, as I mentioned, we operate in 70 countries. And in all those countries, we have events. We pull the world's top events. We pull the world championships.
Mm-hmm.
We do the Asian championships, European championships.
Wow.
The U.S. National Championships and many other events around the world.
Mm-hmm.
So it's exciting. We want to introduce people to our sport.
Yeah.
And we want to introduce people to our boats, and we do that largely through events.
Let me ask you one last question.
Yeah.
A lot of people, of course, they want to learn how to ski. They want to learn how to do the tricks. They want to do the jumps and the surfing. How many people want to learn how to drive?
Oh, everybody loves driving the boats. The boats are fun, and everybody loves driving the boats. So that's you're not out in the water, but that's a lot of fun, too.
We're going to have to investigate that, I think, on another episode. But we're nearing the end of the program for right now. I want to thank Bill Yeargin for joining us tonight. Bill, what is the best way for people to get in touch with you for more information about the company?
CorrectCraft.com. That'll have information about all of our companies and lots of video there of athletes and pictures and boat information, a lot of cool stuff. CorrectCraft.com.
All right. Now, folks, if you have a question or a comment, please email us at wdsc@daytonastate.edu or go to our Facebook page. To check out our schedule, visit our webpage at wdsctv.org, and you can find other episodes of this series and other local programs online at the WDSC YouTube channel. We'll see you next time. Boat safe.